In my work, I strive to achieve several things. First of all, I want to show a world that cannot be seen with naked eyes. A world that have never been seen before. Yes, this world is very similar to our familiar world, but it is not it. This is like a parallel world that exists right alongside ours. A world that is almost the same, but yet different. I hope that through this defamiliarization, the audience will come upon some bright ideas, some new sensations. Some things they will find beautiful, other things horrible. In a few words, what I want to do is to give people the opportunity to see the world from the outside, in a slightly different light, in a non-obvious light, in a light not visible to the naked eye. And then the artist must tackle artistic tasks. After all, modern photography is a very sophisticated art, because there is a lot of photographers, a lot of cameras, an infinite number of photo hostings, an array of photos indistinguishable from one another, and so on. And I wanted to, or rather I needed to, develop my own signature manner, my own style. I wanted people to look at my work and say, oh, this is Arsen. And it is hard. It is particularly difficult to create your own style with photographic means, and it's impossible to do without numerous different experiments, different cameras, different materials and different techniques. Almost all types of cameras that mankind has invented over the last 120 years have passed through my hands, as well as a huge amount of lenses and photographic materials. Autochrome film, panchrome, infrared. I worked with collodion, with Polaroid and with pinhole cameras. I mean, I've tried a lot of various options. Numerous variety of developers. I tested everything and in the end I settled on a few basic techniques. In a few words, there is follows. Firstly, my film has to be large format. Secondly, it must be infrared. The smallest format I work with is medium, but I prefer to shoot on a large format, and in range of large format I also prefer the top sizes. This is 5x7 inches, 8x10 inches, and sometimes in a very rare cases I shoot 11x14 inches. Which is almost A3 format. Why do I need a large format? It's not because I want to get some phenomenal resolution in details. I need it to show the play of light. So that one tree leaf has not just a single quantum of light, that the leaf glistens with at least 6, 7, or 8 lighting points. Infrared film is black and white film, an emulsion of which is added a special infrared sensitizing agent. It is a complex organic cyanochrome substance. There are several different variants of it. These substances are added in a very small quantities, 1 gram per 100 liters of collodion silver solution. And this additive increases the sensitivity of the film to infrared rays. Today, only Rely makes infrared film, and even Rely maximum film size is 120 millimeters. Large format film is no longer produced. Thank God I still have some stock, plus I hope to recover the production. I've now been working hard to create infrared film in my format. Then I put infrared filter on the lens. It is black, non-transparent, or nearly non-transparent. Through this filter, the sun looks like a crimson red disc. It is easy to look at, and everything else is not visible at all. This filter, of course, causes the sensitivity of the film to drop sharply. By 100 or even 200 times. Exposures become huge, from 0.5 seconds to 4 seconds. Given that I use the large format and long focus lens, there is a constant problem with the depth of focus. Orthoformat camera allow you to solve this problem with the help of adjustment. So I incline front board, I do tilt and shift, I try my best to increase the depth of focus. As for non-view cameras, you have to be limited to whatever the possibilities they have. Diaphragms that I use are usually 5.6, rarely 8. Over the last 6 months to a year, I've been working with Alpacam. This is a Swiss work of art. As the quality of design idea, the concept and mechanics reliability, it is a Swiss watch or a Swiss army knife. Brilliant camera. And while it shoots in sizes from 6x6 to 6x9, I use it only for squares. And I shoot landscapes with Linhof. It is a classic Linhof 612 PC camera. There are two options, PC1 and PC2, and I have both. and two lenses, respectively 57 and 120. For Alpa, I use three lenses, 38, 57 and 120. There is another technique that I use, which is not new at all. It is called double exposure. This means that I make a shot and not rewind the film. All my cameras allow you to not rewind the film after each shot, and then I shoot again, a new frame on the same negative. The effect is rather extraordinary. It's not quite like the combination of two negatives during printing or in Photoshop. And you get something very individual and unique. This is very intricate work, and you get very few good photos, but the good ones often drive people crazy. So the negatives are ready. And then there are two ways. The first option is scanning, high resolution on a drama scanner or Imacon. And the second way is a direct analog printing. I use both ways depending on what kind of materials I have. Or I do analog printing, including contact printing. It is easy in large format, for example, platinum contact printing. However, the classic case is scanning and then photo printing using Lambda in the laboratory. To sum up, I'm now where I am. Medium format infrared film, large format platinum. At the same time, there is no guarantee that I will settle on this. I will continue to search, I am constantly in pursuit of something. And it is quite possible that someday something new will emerge, and I certainly hope so.